Welcome to Truckee, California, nestled in the famous Sierra Nevada and next door to beautiful Lake Tahoe. Join me for an absolutely booming day that ended up being my fastest flight to date. I ended up getting sort of a late launch at 1:22 p.m., but that meant that I launched into strong conditions. I had a bit of a scary moment on tow. I was fully ballasted with water.
Bring tow faster, please.
And the tow plane got a little slow at one point, which can be dangerous, especially when you're loaded down with water. It's a good idea to keep your eye on your airspeed when you're towing with water. As usual, I got my initial climbs over an area we call the Hot Rocks, right next to Truckee Airport. I topped out around 14,000 near Mount Rose, and I was off on my first glide toward the Pine Nut Range, which is east of Minden, another famous soaring airport. I'm passing just south of Reno International's Class C airspace, and I'm keeping a sharp lookout for any airliners that are on approach or departure. Here I take a short climb that's in the middle of this blue gap. It wasn't a bad climb, but it really wasn't necessary, and it was weaker than the average thermal, so I really should have skipped that and kept going to these better clouds. Now I'm approaching the north end of the Pine Nut Range, which runs north-south and is a very common route when headed south out of Truckee. Here's a good climb that I take all the way to cloud base, and then I'm off on a convergence line that's running down the Pine Nuts. At the top of the screen, you see my glide ratio for this glide was 66 to 1, and that's thanks to this convergence line I'm on. I'm headed for Mount Siegel, which is on the south end of the Pine Nut Range, and from there I'll see which way looks best. I know I'm generally going south because that's where the clouds are predicted to be today. Here's another short climb that I really should have skipped. It was only 1,000 feet and not that strong. I could have waited for a better climb, given all these great clouds that are ahead of me. The forecast for today predicted significant overdevelopment from this point south, but it turned out to be a bit drier than predicted, so the amount of cloud coverage was actually perfect. There's a blue gap here, which is expected because we're crossing a valley between two different mountain ranges. And here we come upon a major decision point. Which line of clouds do I take, left or right? After a little bit of indecision, I ended up going left because this line had more clouds that were evenly spaced, whereas the other line had one large cloud and some gaps around it. I think this was a good choice. It worked out pretty well. And on the right, you can see that big cloud I was talking about, but after that, it didn't look that great. Here I take a pair of climbs that were pretty strong and got me up to cloud base. There's Mount Patterson on the right with the snow on top of it. Pardon me, I'll be right back. Now we're getting into a really remote part of Western Nevada where there is not much of anything. This is not my favorite place to be. There's very few places to land, and I like to stay high around here. Those were a couple of strong climbs, and now I'm ripping along at 110 knots. My safety airport in this area is Hawthorne, which is back behind me next to the lake. Ahead in the distance, you can see Boundary Peak, which marks the north end of the White Mountains. On my glide computer, you can see that I'm overflying Huntoon Dry Lake. It's marked as a landable, but it does not look very landable to me. Here's another booming thermal. And after this climb, I decided to turn back north. The day has been predicted to end around 4:30 p.m. So I'm trying to get back before the clouds disappear. I'm going back on the same cloud street that I came south on. Is still working well. I take a one circle climb here that was not really necessary, but I think it was strong enough that it didn't hurt my cross country speed at all. Here I'm approaching Hawthorne and Mount Grant again, and I make a turn straight north to fly along this mountain range where Mount Grant is. I noticed in the forecast that this was supposed to be an especially strong area in the afternoon. And it was. Here's Walker Lake on the right side and Mount Grant beneath us. These cloud streets are as good as it gets. I'm able to stay at cloud base without turning, and this kind of flying really makes your cross-country speed go up because you're making forward progress without turning and without losing much altitude. Part of the reason I decided to head due north was to make a triangle out of this flight. There's a small blue gap ahead, so I decided to take a short climb before we cross it. Now, coming up is a part of the flight which I am the least happy with. I take a really weak thermal here.
I've got a 717 miles east of Yerington, climbing through 14.8. How about you?
I'm at 14,800, which is plenty high for this area, but the reason why I got a little nervous is right here. That big, tall cloud is on the north end of the pine nuts. I can see that it's raining underneath it, so that route home is blocked. Instead, I decide to continue north and cross this large blue gap to those clouds in the distance. At the top of my moving map, you can see we're approaching Fallon Naval Air Station, and that blue circle just north of me is some restricted airspace that we're going to have to go around. Fortunately, the best clouds are not inside of it. Now I'm crossing another big blue gap. You see my glide ratio on this leg was only 38 to 1. But those clouds ahead look really good, so I'm expecting good climbs ahead, and I'm keeping my speed up. My safety airport now is Silver Springs, but we are plenty high, so I'm not thinking too much about that right now. Now I'm approaching that big juicy cloud, and I think I probably got saliva running down my chin. And indeed, it turned out to be a good climb. A good couple of climbs, actually. We're getting closer to Truckee now, and I can see that there are good clouds around, so things are looking good. I'm plenty high, and there are lots of airports in range. But we are nearing Reno International, and I've got to keep my eye out for traffic again. I've gotten to the point where I can dial in Truckee to the glide computer, and we are about 1,400 feet below glide, and we need 36 to 1, but we've got plenty of good clouds ahead, so I'm feeling very optimistic about getting back. It's nearing the time when SkySight predicted the clouds and the lift would go away. So I'm taking a couple of weaker climbs just to make sure I get final glide. It sure doesn't look like these clouds are about to disappear, and I'm still getting decent climbs, but it turns out that my buddy 4 Bravo, who was not far behind me, had a much tougher time getting home because things started to evaporate shortly after this. On the right there you see Pyramid Lake. And just to the right of the nose is Air Sailing Gliderport. I'm going to take a one circle climb here, just for insurance. There in the middle of the screen is the city of Reno and Reno International Airport. And on the right is the smaller airport called Reno Stead. Stead is a good landout option if you can't make it back to Truckee. And now I'm about to cross over Reno International airspace. The Class C airspace only goes up to 8,400, but since I don't have ADS-B out, I need to stay above 10,000 MSL. And I'm currently at 11.5. And I get to the edge of the airspace only about 500, 600 feet above 10,000.
Truckee Tower, ladder 7 is 6 miles northeast at 9,000, inbound to land.
Truckee Tower, ladder 2, wind 250-13021, access report, one fine.
Report, one fine, ladder 7.
It's always a good feeling to make it back to your home airport. The headwind on the final glide towards the end there got up to 15 knots, and I lost about 500 feet off my arrival altitude.
Truckee Tower, ladder 7, one fine.
Ladder 7, wind 2608, runway 20, clear to land.
Clear to land 20, ladder 7.
Landing on runway 20 at Truckee is notoriously tricky. Right at the threshold of the runway, there's a cliff. And there is often a very steep wind gradient and sink at the end of the runway. And in addition, you've got those trees on the right side that are often creating turbulence on final. I like to fly my approaches to Truckee with a little extra airspeed, because you easily lose it due to the wind gradient on short final. Ah, smooth as butter. Put the spoilers handle forward and go to negative flaps for better aileron authority at low speed. And I've turned off the angled taxiway here, and the goal is to get past the hold short line, which I just did. And I come to a stop and unfortunately drag the wingtip in the gravel a little bit. That's always hard to avoid at Truckee.
Truckee Tower, glider 7 is clear of 20.
7, thank you. Have a good night.
Let's take a look at that landing again. My aim point is right on the numbers. And I'm flaring and I touch down right next to the second pair of VASI lights, those orange boxes there. And that leaves me with about the right amount of energy to roll out down the angled taxiway, angled turnoff that is, and make it past the hold short line. The tower appreciates it if you can get past the hold short line, because then you are officially clear of the runway. Here's the full flight trace, 491 kilometers at 131 kilometers per hour, about 4 hours. That's my fastest flight to date by a decent margin, so I'm pretty happy with that. Still, there were areas to improve. There were a few tries that could have been avoided, a few weak climbs that could have been avoided, but overall, I was pretty good about holding out for the stronger climbs, which were pretty easy to find today. Today was an easy day, which was nice. After that very stressful flight in Nephi, it was nice to have a easy, fast, fun flight out of Truckee. I have a question for you glider pilots out there. Did you enjoy seeing every thermal in this video? Or could you have done without some of them? Let me know. And also, did you enjoy seeing the entire flight? Or would you have preferred to see just the highlights? Let me know in the comments. Thanks.